Brown. This is Weapons Tech Matt coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. And tonight I'm just come home from a heavy duty day at the range. We did 100 yard shooting, 25 yard shooting, 15 and 7 with the pistol, and then gave the old JTS shotgun a workout. And I'll probably do a follow-up video on the JTS shotgun. Worked flawlessly. I put another 50 rounds through that baby. And it could just chug them out as fast as you pull the trigger. No hang-ups, no nothing. But anyway, the reason why I'm coming to you on this, it's not going to be a very long video. It'll be, I don't particularly like doing how-to videos very much. I'll watch them. I get a lot of information on those folks that do that. But, you know, I guess sometimes I just don't want to get out there I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to do kind of a how-to, and that's my experience coming through as a gunner's mate in the Navy. And an old Master Chief gunner's mate used to chew our ass if we didn't clean our guns and our rifles and pistols very good. But I'm going to show you what you think looks like a clean pistol, and it ain't. And so I'll give you some of the old Master Chief's wisdom. And, you know, as you can see right behind me here, I've got these tins here of some of the guns that we used at the range today. And I bring them in and unpack and then tear the gun down and then spray it with Ballistol or Rim Oil or CLP or whatever the hell it is I got on hand there, and just let it soak. And then I'll come out, scrub it a bit, run a, you know, bore brush through their barrels, and again, let them soak. And then come out and really get after cleaning them. So I'm going to kind of show you, I've been working on a couple of 45s. Took 3 45s out today shooting. And I'll get the first one. I have it already, you know, I'm cleaning it. But I also work on the barrels. And usually I'll have 3 different barrels while I'm cleaning the the slide and the frame of the gun. I'll be working on 3 different barrels because the barrel is the thing that's the most difficult to get clean. At least clean in my mind and what was drilled into my head from that old gunner's mate, Master Chief, as to what the hell clean is. So I'm just going to kind of move this right over here, and we'll look and talk about clean. All right, so here you see I've got some tins with these guns that I've pulled apart, and usually I'll soak them down and then scrub them with a toothbrush or whatever and then wipe them out. Of course, I'm using either Ballistol Hops number 9, or Rim Oil, all of the above. Sometimes I know you really shouldn't mix solvents and things, so I try not to, but just kind of give that a rub down, okay? But the thing is, I've already run, I don't know how many patches and things through this barrel, and even the old snake, boar snake. And some people say, oh, that's good, we'll just leave it good right there. And see here, I've got 3 barrels I'm working with. This here's the Dan Wesson for the gun I've got right there. Let's see if I can show you how clean that looks in there. You think it looks clean? So get my light working here. Let's see. So you see it looked pretty clean in there, right? All right. So I'll run a patch through. Yeah, I'll run a patch. Usually I put the patch on the outside of a, like a, these are 45, so a brush for a 40. And I'll run a patch through. And see, that doesn't look too bad, right? You think, okay, that thing is shiny, it's clean. Well, guess what? That's what the old Master Chief would do. He'd get a 45 bore brush, soak it down in some Ballistol, or CLP or whatever the heck you're using. Then run it through. Now this is a clean bore brush, mind you. Clean bore brush. And let it soak for a minute or two, a couple of seconds. Now we got a clean patch here, yeah. And I'm gonna put it on this. And I'm gonna run it through. Look at that. That is not clean. And that old Master Chief said, Petty Officer McDaniels, you better get on board my bandwagon. You gotta clean your gun like you wipe your butt until it stops coming out dirty. So that's just my little take on how you clean that. Now another thing I'll do to kind of clean out the magwell, I'll take this used bore brush and very carefully put it with a patch that's been soaked down, put it up inside there, and it'll clean stuff out, okay? Now the bore brush is completely covered. Of course, it's totally covered by the, and that'll help clean some of that crap out up in there. All right, so that's just a few of my little thing. Let's see how these other coming out. And I'll do that multiple times. I don't think you're ever gonna get it completely, perfectly, 100% clean. But that's a little take from the Master Chief. All right, so I figured I'd show you a little bit about oiling and lubing. And, you know, the old saying, a happy gun is an oiled gun. So usually what I'll do after I've cleaned everything up decent, I'll give them a quick little burst of Barricade. I've been using Barricade for at least a dozen years, and I got no problems with it. Just a little shot on everything. Okay. Then, get down dirty here, and get me a swab, and I just use Hops number 9 oil, and I'm gonna lube up a little bit extra where metal touches metal for the most part, like right in here. Cut that up. Like I said, I've always liked my guns to be a bit wet. There's that. I'm gonna get in here. Oh, this is still kind of covered pretty good with Barricade. In there, underneath. I'm gonna get this barrel a little bit, rub it around. Get up in here. Okay. Yep. Bushy. So everything's got a little oil on it. The other thing I'll do is I'll get a swab. Put some Barricade on the swab. Run it through the barrel a couple of times. I always like that barrel to be nice and oiled inside. Yeah, just like that. And then you put it together. All right, so there she is, all clean, all ready to roll. And listen, Vigil Commander, and all lubed up. Mind you, you probably have a little bit of lube coming out in the back here every once in a while as you're racking it around, but that's okay. The other thing while you're cleaning, get some good music on. Got a little Creedence going right now. But, enjoy cleaning your guns. Don't make it some labor of hate. Make it a labor of love, because a good, clean gun is going to take care of you when you need it the most. If it's all dirty and nasty, you know, you don't have a for sure thing that it's going to work. So, here's my little fun thing on cleaning and lubing. Oh, one thing I needed to add that, you know, there'll probably be somebody to bitch and complain the way I'm cleaning these things. But understand, main thing is clean your damn guns, all right? Whether you have any kind of other method or whatever, at least run a swab patch through the barrel, clean it up a bit. Especially with some of the crap ammo we're going to be getting. Especially you shoot that steel case stuff. Yeah, most of my guns will run that stuff, but it's going to be dirty. And you definitely need to clean them up. Like real soon after shooting them. I'm sorry, I just don't trust the ammunition manufacturer saying, oh, no, it's not going to corrode or anything like that. And just get after it, clean it up, and then it don't matter whether it's going to corrode or not. After you cleaned it up, you got a clean gun. And, you know, if you don't like the way I do it, find some way that you do it. And a lot of my friends think I'm a bit too fanatical about getting that side of the barrel clean. Of course, that was just stuck to me when in the Navy, like I explained to you. But clean them up. Make them worthwhile to shoot, and make the cleaning session a fun thing. And you got kids, boys and girls, show them how to clean a gun. Show them proper gun procedures. Show them that there's no reason for somebody to get hurt cleaning a gun. Treat the dang gun like it's always loaded, and double check all the time. Have I had an inadvertent discharge? One time I did, several years back, in my den and then my gun room. I've got my safes in there, and I also have a sword cabinet made out of cedar wood that I built years ago. And I had this little Ivor Jennings TP22, and it's a Walther PPK knockoff. It's one of those. Walther PP knockoff, and it was a little tiny thing. I thought it was emptied. I cleared it a couple of times, and it didn't clear very good. I didn't check, and then stupidly, you know, after you rack it back, oh, there's nothing in there, and then rather than setting the hammer down, you just pull the trigger. Well, I pulled the trigger, and that 22 went off, hitting that cedar sword cabinet case, put a nice little hole. It hit where one of the knots were, you know, the knots in the wood, which is a very tough spot, and the bullet got seated right there. And I've kept that way since I did that like 6-7 years ago. In fact, the spent casing is right along with the hole in the cedar cabinet. In fact, I'll probably take a picture of it, and you see that cedar wood with the hole and the spent casing. That's there to remind me, always treat these suckers like they're loaded, and verify, is the barrel empty? You might have racked it back, but are you sure that ejector, extractor, and all that stuff's working proper? So, that's kind of my safety tape. All right, so one of the things I use is these tins I picked up at Walmart. They're for dogs, dog food. They're like $3.98 each, and they're made out of solid metal. And they don't interact with the solvents or anything like that. I just like to break my guns down, keep all the parts in the bin, like you can see right here. And of course, this is a 45. I was working on the barrel over there at my other workbench. But you know, you take care of your guns, you keep them clean, and they're gonna take care of you, and they're gonna last a long time. You know, if you don't take care of them, you're going to end up getting dirty, rusty, gummed up guns that are not going to work, especially when you need them. And so that's kind of my take at having a clean gun, getting after as soon as you get back from the range. Some people just hate cleaning their guns. You know, if you got the money, get somebody to clean for you. If you don't, I used to hate cleaning my guns. I'll tell you, I put off, all kinds of excuses not to clean them. And you know, the one thing that kind of changed that is every time I go out and shoot, whether it's with family members, friends, or whatever, you know, they're all, and we're all trying the various guns out and having a good time. And I try to remember that particular gun and the times I've had with it in the past. Now, if it's a brand new one, then it's a brand new gun. That's also got a excitement about it. And so, you know, keep them all well cleaned and well lubed and oiled. An oiled gun, a lubed gun is a happy gun. And, you know, I'll just sign off from there. This is Weapons Tech Mac coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. God bless Texas. God bless the United States. And long live the Republic.
Find anywhere. Hey, I'm not trying to be nobody.